tank. You know what I'm saying? We have a think tank. And what the whole objective for the think tank is to make sure it's full. You know what I'm saying? Make sure our think tank, not a think tank, but think, T-H-A-N-S, that, you know, think full tank. And the problem is this, because it's pretty much a reminder, our think tank, when it's full, is the reminder of really the reality of life. You know what I'm saying? The reality of life, that first of all, we didn't create anything. You know, we don't have anything. There's nothing a human being has in this earth. We don't have nothing. We came as what Job, a true servant of God, understood concerning praise and worship and being thankful. You came in here with nothing. You leave here with nothing. You know what I'm saying? You don't have nothing. You really, but this world system wants you to think that you have something and things belong to you. And then now, you cannot truly be thankful for what you have. And now your praise is not going to be sincere. Your praise is not going to be sincere unto God. Not how good you sing and speak unto people, but your heart, your praise is not going to be sincere unto God. But singing is supposed to remind us. You know, it's supposed to remind us. It's supposed to be about a remind us of the reality of the truth, that we do not have nothing, but God has everything. That's what true praise within your mind. I don't have nothing, but God has everything. And what, if you study, you know, Psalms, you will hear that pattern in David's songs, that, you know, I'm nothing without you. You know what I'm saying? You have everything, God. I'm nothing. So if I realize that, I know how much I need God and how much of who God is. That's the next step of true praise. Now God starts to reveal himself of who he is. You know, I love, you know, Psalms 24. You know what I'm saying? Who is the King of glory? The Lord that's strong and mighty. Who is the King of glory? The Lord that's mighty in battle. See, David, if you read that from the beginning, it said, you know, it talks about the earth is the Lord's. First of all, I don't have an earth. David acknowledged that the earth is the Lord's. I don't got an earth. You know what I'm saying? And the thing is, and the earth is Lord's and the fullness thereof and everything that is in it. Everything is yours, God. I don't have it. And it's to realize that in all sincereness, I don't have nothing. But this world system wants you to believe that you have something because you worked for it, you got money, and you purchased something, and it's yours, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, it belongs to you because it's yours, you know? And it's trying to build a selfish mindset. Well, develop a selfish mindset because I got this in this mind, so I'm not going to give nothing. You know, it's trying to get people to develop that mindset, unfortunately. But true praise is about understanding, as what King David says, the earth is the Lord's, the fools therein. Now you acknowledge what's his. Now God starts to reveal himself to you. And in that sequence of reading that, I think in the 10th of Psalms 24, who is the King of glory? The Lord, the strong and mighty. Now King David can see God for who he is and see God for more of who he is. How much more who he is, and how much more we see God for who he is how much is required of us to give. Let me say that again. How much we see God for more who he we will understand how much is required for us to give him. You know what I'm saying? It's what I can tell most Christians don't understand the true praise and worship, because, you know, now worship comes. Now, I see God in his greatness. Now, what do I give him? You know what I'm saying? It's called Romans 12, you know what I'm saying? And 12:1-2, you know, I present my whole body, all my body, as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable and pleasing unto God for his reasonable service. That is the worship, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, and now I can't be not conformed to this world. See, that's what I was talking about. The world is trying to make you believe that I got this. This is my shirt. This is my jacket. This is my body. This is my eyes. These my nose. This, no, they're not. You didn't create them. You didn't create your body. You didn't. You are a procreation. You know what I'm saying? Someone has already created you from the beginning. You know what I'm saying? But when when we get this understanding that, oh, this is mine, that's when Satan now is concerning in the position to deceive you concerning the lust of the flesh. That's how we get it. Now, and the thing is, but when we see who God is, God, we know it requires us to become a living sacrifice for his reasonable service, not for your reasonable service, but for his reasonable service. And that, now watch this. When you praise God, you elevate him and he will elevate you spiritually. When you elevate God, what I just present to you, a praise and worship concerning your heart and assessing of it based upon being thankful towards him, he exalt you based upon that. He exalt you as much as you exalt him. And guess what? Then God can tell you to do this because you're his servant. He'll tell you to do this. He'll tell you to do that. And he'll tell you to do things, of course, unfortunately, contrary to what's going on, whether it's in the world and whether it's in the church. You know what I'm saying? He will elevate you based upon that, of you seeing who he is. And as what Jesus says, you know, God is spirit and they shall worship him, must worship in spirit and truth. And that's why I can tell, you know, unfortunately, a church system is not worshiping and exalting God in spirit and truth because of how they're not seeing him in all of who he is. Now, they can sing it, they can preach it, but if they see him for all of who he is, a church will be sincerely to follow the scriptures concerning the word of God of what it's saying. You know what I'm saying? That when you see the all requirement, because the thing is, it's right there, you know, love the Lord thy God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind. It's right there. But certain Christians don't understand that they should require all to them. They think but here's the thing. Yeah, I need to clarify this. See, God is seeking for a genuine decision. He does not want to force you or push you, but what he will try to do is put you in a position for you to see spiritually. He will put you in a position for you to see your condition, to where you're at and where you need to be if you want to be with him. You know what I'm saying? He will do things in your day. He will position you to help you see that, look, I would like you to do this concerning to require of you for you to do that. You know what I'm saying? To try to be on the aim to give him all. You know what I'm saying? Like, for instance, you know, like I told this person that get saved, you don't give all your life to God. You know what I'm saying? You don't, like people think, you know, when you get saved, when you say, I confess with your mouth and believe in your heart, I'm saved and I gave all my life to him. No, you didn't give it all to him yet. But when you start giving your time, your energy, your knowledge, you're yielding your knowledge to learn his word and to perform his word each and every day, that's when you are giving him your life. That's when you giving him your time, your knowledge, you're yielding your brain to learn the word of God, and your energy, you're doing and applying the word of God. That is when you're giving your life to him. And that's where the worship, true worship, is required, is done. When you start doing his word, living his word, and stuff like that. But watch this. When you praise and worship God, it's a form of expression of what you're giving him. You know what I'm saying? In the natural. Yeah, the natural worship. Oh, yeah. The natural worship is like we lift our hands. We're expressing what's within inside of ourselves of how much we give unto him daily, each and every day. That is the reflection. That's not you giving all your life to him. That's just supposed to be the reflection of what you have been giving him on your daily life. And the thing is, the more you truly worship God, and now in spiritual of service, of true service unto God, then truth, you will have a desire and motivation to do truth in spite of what people say and what, in spite of what people do, in spite of what everybody else is doing. You will be motivated to do and learn the truth and perform the truth and present the truth. See what I'm saying? Because that's like, as what you see Jesus' life, Jesus wasn't afraid to tell the scribes and Pharisees the truth. You know what I'm saying? He wasn't afraid to tell the truth to people. You know what I'm saying? Because he's not living for the appease people, appease anybody, but to please his Father in heaven concerning the will of God. He was on that agenda. Like, the disciples left him. Bam, they gone. People want him crucified. He's not here for people's opinion or approval. He's here for one thing, of the be about the truth. And the truth was, he's the Lamb of God and he needs to be slain for the sins of this world. Is what the ideal of truly worshiping God as the song, give myself away, as what Jesus gave his flesh away with 39 lashes, that was worship unto God. You know what I'm saying? Giving him all his self to him, his life, all everything, bam. That's the ideal of worship, is what we supposed to understand, that requirement, and serve towards that requirement when we truly learn how to praise and worship him concerning that. And I hope this can help you understand praise and worship for what it is. And when you praise with your lips and worship with it, it's supposed to help motivate you and motivate others to truly, natural praise and worship is supposed to help you motivate you to spiritually praise and worship God. That's what I hope you understand. When you naturally praise God and worship naturally, it's supposed to help you be thankful and to exalt God for who he is, and to worship, to yield yourself for service to whatever God commands you to do on your daily life activities, is what true praise and worship. And when you go continue that, you will understand that I surrender all song more. Yeah, I surrender all, and there's more to surrender, and there's more to surrender, and there's more to surrender, and it goes to infinity. Yeah, it is what it is, because we serve a forever God. It's to infinity. He deserves all. He deserves everything that we need to give him. And that's what true worship is supposed to understand, the requirement of all, and all needs to be given, and all needs to be done in spite of what people say, in spite of what people do, in spite of the trials and situations and circumstances that come in your life. All needs to be required to perform the things of God. That's what praise and true praise and worship is all about. All right, that's the message. God be glory to him forever and ever. In Jesus' name, amen.